small celled bees. The question that came up yesterday, printed foundation, about 5.4 mils per cell, 10 cells if you measure it across will come out about 54 millimetres. Bees in natural conditions will tend to build rather smaller than that. My bees are around about, my bees work about 5.2 mils. Some people find they go down as small as 4.9 mils. Sometimes you get a mix. Sometimes you'll get 4.9, 5.2, you know, 5.6, 6.4 being the drone, and they will build everything in between. What my bees did was they were commercial bees originally, about 4 or 5 years ago. They went from 5.4 mils on their foundation down to 5.2. And I thought, well, they've stopped regressing, as it's called now. Nope, the next year, we're happy with 5.2 mils diameter, but we want 32 mils spacing instead of 35 mils spacing. So that was a bee behaviour thing. So they'd say, okay, well, we're happy with the cell size, now what we want is the cones close together, please. So I gave it to them, and this just gives me the flexibility to play with that, because I can size that whatever size I want to. The point I'm trying to get across is there is a very natural shape, size, and distinction between the brood area and the honey storage area. So all this nonsense about you need a queen excluder, otherwise the poor girl doesn't want to know where to lay, it's just nonsense. And that will vary from year to year, depending on the season. This year I'm not going to get any surplus honey unless we get a massive flow, simply because it's been such a changeable weather and the honey, the nectar's it's been very intermittent and they haven't built up very much. Last year was completely the opposite. By this time last year I had huge hives bursting with bees. So again, it changes year to year. So you build your hive up, then you will find your into honey storage. And then you'll go on as the honey flow progresses, and you know you find that once you get up here somewhere, you're thinking, gosh, how much are they going to need for next winter? I've got more than enough in the hive. I can actually take a bar of honey out of the end.
How'd you make that judgment?
I would want to see at least 10 to 12 bars pretty full of honey
before I take one out.
And that's excluding what's in here. Because at the time I take a bar of honey out at the end, if the nectar flow stops tomorrow because the weather changes, that's what they've got for the year.
Mm.
Now, last year we had a very heavy ivy flow that came right through until late October, and they filled all this during the summer. Well, actually, by this time of the year, they stopped them completely because we had a drought. Nothing came in after the third week in June until the middle to the end of September. Suddenly, had this amazingly heavy ivy flow, which they backfilled into the brood because they, at that stage, they'd stopped rearing, well, they'd cut down on their brood rearing. Mm. But I didn't know that we were going to have a heavy ivy flow, so I just took a couple of bars out at the end here, left about 12 bars, and they were weighing 2.5 kilos each.
Wow.
They were heavy bars. You know, you're talking about a bag of sugar each bar. That's why I had a lot of collapsed comb. So that was fine. And then when the ivy flow came in, I was able to say, okay, well, I can take another couple out at the end here because they can spare them. That goes back to the thing of only take what you know to be absolutely circus. I'm going to gallop along a little bit because I want to use other things. If, however, you say,